saying?
Superintendent of Davidson County Schools, Ms. Julie Hamilton, Assistant Superintendent Human Resources, Ms. Donna Stafford, Chief Public Information Officer, Ms. Leanne Tuttle Thomas, CTE Director and Board of Advisors, Jamie Hudson, Board of Advisors, Brian Feaser, Davidson County School Board and Board of Advisors, Christy Cook, 2016 and 17 Teacher of the Year, Cinda Wooten, 2017 and 18 Teacher of the Year.
At this time, I'd like to call Ms. Heather Jones to the stage to give a tribute to our graduates.
Justin rallies the crowd, proclaiming, "This is a lot like that time I wrecked my car going through that thunderstorm." Maybe he's looking for a refreshment cart to reenact that crash. To which Trey replies, let me tell you, it's going to be a whole lot worse than that. Robbie, Brandon, and Preston have already reached the cockpit. The captain is panicked and injured, probably having thrown in his back playing golf, and it's clear that the plane is in trouble. The boys quickly start assessing the problem and trying to save the plane. Could it be something electrical? As debates in the cockpit rage, Hallie, Gigi, and Sarah have already figured out it's mechanical. Jill and Jordan declare that they can fix it and get to work building parts for the broken wing with old paper. While Alondra reroutes the flight to keep everyone on track and safe, Bria, Jocelyn, Jalen, and Josh work to keep everyone calm with jokes. Nervous laughter, but laughter all the same. Matthew and Allison immediately start to check on everybody, then turn their attention to taking care of the wounded pilot. He's in very good hands. With work on the spare parts quickly completed, Hallie successfully shimmies out onto the wing of the plane to repair the broken parts while McKenna, hammer in hand, documents these pieces of heroism in pictures. Back in coach, the senior class is beginning to get wind of the crisis in first class. Westbrook sits struggling to peel mashed avocado from the inside of his carry-on. Dylan, as he peeks through to first class, passes out of the sight of the chaos into the fifth years and faints in a sudden panic. Lori leaps to her feet to assist her fallen classmate, proclaiming, I got you, as she takes charge, while Milan holds Dylan's hand, calming him down. Tiffany, attempting to sneak up to first class to see Brandon, realizes what's happening. It hits her like a fastball to the gut. Something's wrong with the plane. Ilana, trying to touch up her makeup when the disaster began, freezes, both in fear and so as not to smear it. Samantha looks up from her phone, rolls her eyes as the plane gives another violent shake, and says simply, really? With all that turbulent chaos, luggage starts to fly. Molly immediately hulks out and grabs carry-ons, littering the floor, clearing the aisle so no one gets hurt. As the plane begins to rattle a bit, David and Drake aren't worried. David begins writing a rap about the impending crash, asking, what rhymes with impact? While Drake documents the chaos around him in art form using his beloved Google Draw. Mike already has his own take on things, declaring that he knew this would happen. This is a conspiracy that goes all the way to the top, and the pilot is in on it. Jenny and Haley are doing their best to keep the mood light, and they begin sharing their mad libs with the group for a laugh in times of trouble. Again, nervous laughter is better than no laughter, and for all the noise, a quiet Palmer group emerges. Cece, Daniela, and Summer start calculating and discussing everyone's odds of survival. Tayja and Lindsay are working to keep order in coach, keeping everyone seated and calm while Dakota, who's been doodling on an air flight napkin, goes along behind him and offers words of wisdom for those who are upset. It's touch and go for a few minutes while the fifth year struggles to regain control of the aircraft. But with the know-how of the graduates, the plane is able to begin a rocky descent toward PTI. Passengers and crew safe, if not a little shaken up. As the flight ends and the aircraft comes to a safe landing on the runway, the wounded captain reappears on the intercom. Probably weak and exhausted, but thankful to be there, and still endlessly positive about it all. Hey, hey, hey! Sorry about that mild setback, folks. I hope you enjoyed your flight just as much as I did. I know I liked it so much, I'm going to do it again tomorrow. The announcement awakens Alexei from a long nap, earbuds in her ears, Korean pop music at full volume. She has no idea that they were ever in trouble. She doesn't realize anything's out of place until Sam Souls arises from the back of the coach, sprints up the aisle, kicks open the emergency hatch, and leads his classmates to safety, freedom, and the next step of that journey. That's what really matters now, that next step. Your time at Valley wasn't without its challenges for every single one of you. But life isn't always about being right or always having all the answers. It's about having the tools to get to those answers, the humility to ask for help when you can't find them, the motivation and the drive to get there, and the ability to take something and make it your own. The wisdom to know that even in the hard times, especially in those hard times, you learn more about yourself than you'll ever be able to predict. You're leaving Valley maybe not with all the answers or even an idea of what the next year of your life's going to look like, and that's part of growing up. You're going to be unsure of yourself, and you're going to fail at something, big or small. You're going to meet people who are nothing like you, people you like and people you don't, and you're going to have to grin and bear it and be the bigger person sometimes. You're going to have moments when you want to throw up your hands, maybe a textbook, possibly, but hopefully not, a wrench or an expensive computer, and question everything you've done and want to quit sometimes. You were told when you started your journey at Valley that you were building an airplane while flying it, and that's a nearly impossible task. But you all made it here. You built it, and it's still flying. Life always has turbulence. Sometimes it's a little rough patch, and sometimes it's life-changing. And all you have is you and what you've learned along the way to get you through it. That's why life demands people like you, who can adapt, who take failure as a lesson, not as a defeat, who see a problem and ask, how can I fix it, or how can I help? Because that's the kind of people that Valley students are at the end of the day. Even when things get tough, you get through it. You find something positive to hang on to, and you get it done. The one thing that kept coming back to me as I finished writing this was how much we laughed as we put all these ideas together, and how many amazing little things you guys said and did, sometimes probably without realizing it, to completely completely blew our minds and sometimes turned bad days around for us. The things that came up again and again were the things like your loves of photography, your smiles, the times you made us laugh, how you turned into not just young professionals but leaders, the way you would help people in need and brought out the best in each other, not because you had to, but because it was what the school should be about. With who you've become throughout your time at Valley and with what you've learned here, the knowledge, the skills, and the life lessons that you couldn't have come by anywhere else, the sky is no limit to what the class of 2017 can accomplish. Congratulations, guys.
Hello, my name is Keyshawn Coleman, and I'm the Vice President of our student government. At this time, I will recognize our honor graduates. To earn summa cum laude, student GPA must be 4.5 or higher. For magna cum laude, student GPA must be 4.1 to 4.49. A cum laude designation requires a weighted GPA of 3.63 to 4.09. Please stand and remain standing when your name is called. Molly Leonard, magna cum laude. Lori Fernandez, magna cum laude. Trey Roach, cum laude. McKenna Zuki, cum laude. Brandon Johnson, cum laude. Brandy Latham, cum laude. Matthew Petro, cum laude. Dylan Silver, cum laude. Please give these students a round of applause.
At this time, I do want to recognize one super senior in particular. As Ms. Jones referenced, sometimes it did feel like we were building the plane as we were going down the runway. But the unique thing about our school is we have a lot of firsts. So this year, we have our first fifth year, our super seniors. Within that fifth year, those guys have accomplished so much, not only high school diplomas, but over 40 accreditations from the community college, including certificates, diplomas, and associate's degrees. So I do want to take a second and applaud your achievements for that fifth year class. So keeping in mind with first, we do have a first day, to my knowledge. This is our first scholarship that one of our students has earned through the fifth year. At this time, I would like to recognize Mr. Matthew Petro. Matthew, if you will come up, please. Matthew is the recipient of the Ike Kearney Memorial Scholarship, and he will continue his career at DCCC, finishing up his laboratory technician degree next year. We are proud of you, Matt. Congratulations. Hey, we're almost there, guys. Smile. So, to formally welcome Eric, good morning to our esteemed guests, friends, family of our graduates, and most importantly, good morning to the class of 2017. What an honor and privilege it is to welcome you here today on this beautiful Saturday morning as we come together to join and celebrate a milestone in your life, graduation from Valley Academy. At this time, I would like to ask for all grandparents and parents in the audience to please stand. Students, please give these guys a round of applause. You may be seated. I think it's important to honor the people who have made it possible for you to be here today. Included as any part of any great celebration is a time of reflection and a moment of looking ahead. Of all the moments you'll forget about your high school experience, this is the one day you will remember for a lifetime as it begins a new chapter in your life. From kindergarten to today, you have spent approximately 3,510 days in school, or roughly 74% of your life. And if you're a super senior, even more. Many of you, your fondest memories will come from the time you spent at Valley. As you become graduates today, I want you to remember one very important fact, and that is, I believe in you. To move in today's world, you must be willing to do things you've never done before. You must be willing to take a chance, knowing it's better to try and fail than have regret for not trying at all. It's hard to believe today is finally here. Your parents and your family are proud of you. I want you to know that I am proud of you. As you leave Valley Academy, remember that you've been given one lifetime and one journey, just different choices to make and chances to take. Opportunity will not seek you out. It's your responsibility to hunt it down. And if you can't find it, I encourage you to create it. How do you create it? You get in the game. You recognize the task before you, and you dive in with your whole mind and your whole heart. I firmly believe that life is about getting in the game and doing all you can to drive yourself towards success, even if you know failure is a possibility. Some of the most influential businessmen and successful athletes of all time failed while achieving success. Let's take Michael Jordan, for example. Pretty good basketball player. About his career, and I quote, Michael says, "I have missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I was trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. I have failed over and over again in my life, and that is why I've succeeded." Then let's take a college dropout, a fired tech executive, initially an unsuccessful businessman. That's Steve Jobs. And he's best known for his incredible success in guiding Apple in transforming the computer and the phone industry. But he'll also be remembered fondly as the poster child of how making mistakes and even failing can sometimes end up being the best thing that ever happens to you. It's okay to fail in the pursuit of your success, and I hope that the possibility of failure never daunts your quest for success. If you look around at one another today, you will see your class is made up of people from all different walks of life, but with just different sets of talents. However, you're here today, together, basking in the same accomplishment. No matter how you chose to get here, you did not allow potential failure to stop you. So as you prepare to graduate and make your mark on the world, I encourage you to do it with diligence and enthusiasm. I hope you take the time to discover your purpose and take responsibility for the task before you. Please assign yourself your own curriculum in life. Decide what you want to accomplish each day, and think about how your decisions affect others. Be in the thick of it, work hard, and expect those around you to do the same. Never ask somebody to do something you would not do yourself. Be self-aware, be honest, and face reality. Know who you are and listen to your heart. Know where you're strong and know where you're weak. This is one of the hardest things to do because we naturally want to believe we are the best at everything, but we're not. Admitting and recognize our weaknesses, however, makes us strong. If a decision doesn't seem right, don't do it. It's so much better to humbly change your mind than to make a bad decision just to save face. Be strong enough and confident enough to take hits to your ego, whether you believe they are deserved or not. Always remember to surround yourself with good people and be somebody other people want to be surrounded by. It's through positive and sustaining relationships we achieve success. Be willing to step outside your comfort zone, take risks in your careers, your hobbies, in your relationships, or in anything. Put yourself directly on the field and be an active participant, not a spectator. Don't wait for approval. Do something and make it meaningful. Always be willing to learn, for it's the process of learning that we have become uncomfortable because we don't know it all. Have enough confidence in yourself to be willing to take chances. People you love and respect may tell you that it won't work, but be persistent and be willing to accept rejection and failure. Successful people fail, they learn from it, and move on. This means you need to work hard, know what you want, and be willing to achieve it. Make sure everything adds up to a life you can be proud of. Please, please, please appreciate the small things. Remember the warmth of the sun on your face, and relish in the joy of family and friends, and please appreciate the feeling of accomplishment. And most importantly, do not, and I mean do not, spend time worrying about things that you cannot control. You will be given the opportunity to make the game-winning shot. Take it no matter what the outcome may be. For it's through the willingness to fail, we can appreciate the satisfaction of success. Over 2 decades ago, I was sitting in your seat, and someone gave me some advice from a song, The River, by Garth Brooks. Now, I hope you guys know who Garth Brooks is. I feel confident most of the audience will. But just in case you didn't, Google it, download it, whatever you guys do with your computers. But it is from the song, The River, and it says, "Don't stand along the shoreline and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tides." It has been my pleasure to be your principal, and I wish you the best in your future endeavors. And again, congratulations to the class of 2017. Seniors and super seniors, please prepare to receive your diplomas. Seniors and super seniors, after receiving your diploma from Mr. Brown, staff of Valley Academy would like to present each of you with your first dollar earned as a Valley graduate. Building upon your entrepreneurial spirit, make this dollar the first of many more to come. First, I will honor the seniors, Westbrook Edward Baumgartner. Alexei Elizabeth Danik. Jenny Samantha Duncan. Samantha K. Eggers. Alana Mary Evans. Lori Mabel Fernandez, Diploma Pharmacy Technology. Quantasia Demetrius Gilbert. Michael Dean Lambeth, Certificate CTI Fundamentals. Molly Catherine Leonard. Dakota Wayne Overstreet, in absentia. Lindsay Nicole Pettigo. Haley Ariel Pesqueda. Mulan Monica Faye. Daniela Yahara Pineda Ramos. Keely Celeste Richter, in absentia. Dylan Anthony Silver. Samuel Souls, in absentia. Tiffany Michelle Stanley. Summer Lee Stevens. David Michael Truman. Drake Harrison Whitehead. Now I will honor our fifth year super seniors. Bria Michelle Anderson. Certificate CTI Fundamentals and Certificate Digital Media. Preston Lewis Ball. Associate CTI Networking and Cybersecurity. Certificate CTI Fundamentals and Certificate Cisco Networking. Jocelyn Kaya Foy. CTI Fundamentals.
Way to go,
Jay. Allison Marie Griffith. Certificate Nurse Aide. Jalen Ezra Hatcher. Justin Bruce Hatfield, Certificate CNC Fundamentals. Robert Flay Scott Hughes, Associate CTI Networking and Cybersecurity, Certificate CTI Fundamentals, and Certificate Cisco Networking. Jillian Merritt Hudson, Associate Electronics Engineering Technology, Certificate Mechatronics, and Diploma in Electronics Engineering Technology. Brandon Tyler Johnson, Associate CTI Software and Web Development, Certificate CTI Fundamentals, and Certificate Mobile Application Design. Randy Lee Latham, Associate Pharmacy Technology, Diploma Pharmacy Technology. Sarah Elizabeth Maldonado, Associate Computer Integrated Machining, Drafting and Design, Certificate CNC Fundamentals. Austin Kentrell Martin, Associate Pharmacy Technology, Diploma Pharmacy Technology. Alondra Viane Martinez, Certificate Global Logistics and Distribution Management. Allie Catherine Nifon, Certificate Machining Fundamentals. Matthew Ryan Petro, Medical Laboratory Technician. Susie Giselle Placentia, Associate Computer Integrated Machining, Drafting and Design, Certificate Machining Fundamentals, Certificate CNC Fundamentals, Diploma Computer Integrated Machining. Jack William Roach, Associate Computer Integrated.
Administrative Machining, Computer Numerical Control, Certificate CNC Fundamentals, Certificate Machining Fundamentals, Certificate Advanced CNC, and Diploma Computer Integrated Machining. Gordon Tyler Smith, Associate Electronics Engineering Technology, Certificate Mechatronics, and Diploma Electronics Engineering Technology. Joshua David Wagner, McKenna Kate Zuki, Associate CTI Digital Media, Certificate CTI Fundamentals, Certificate Digital Media. Graduates, please stand. On behalf of Davidson County Schools, Valley Academy, and the Board of Advisors, I officially declare you graduates. You may turn your tassel.